The number one fear most people have is public speaking, especially for those that are introverted, like myself. And it definitely was that way for me until I discovered these seven public speaking tips for introverts. And these aren't the typical tips that you're gonna get at a Toastmasters meeting. And in this video, I'm gonna go through the exact process that I've went through to curb my fear of public speaking. It's Tom Jacobs here. If you are new to the channel, this is all about taking those presentations, creating performances so that you have more profits in your business, especially for the solo practitioner and the solopreneur. And it's all about creating that better sales process so that you can impact more people. Even as an introvert, I still get nervous when I have to do some public speaking, whether that's at a networking event for 20 people or on a stage in front of hundreds of people. And even on webinars, I get a little nervous as well. And that's kind of normal, I think, for most people. I use that fear and that nervousness to really energize me so that when I give a presentation, it is the ultimate performance and the audience really enjoys it. And I want you to discover these same seven tips that I've developed to help me give a really killer presentation. Number one, you have to know your audience. If you don't know who you're speaking to, that can create a lot of anxiety because you're like, oh, what if they don't like me? Who are they? What are they gonna judge me about? Am I gonna be talking what they want to be hearing? All of those little thoughts create that anxiety within you. So make sure you know exactly who your audience is, what they're looking to get out of it, and ultimately how you're going to interact with them so that you give them the best performance that you can. Tip number two, and this may seem a little woo-woo or a little weird maybe, but I like to know the room. I like to actually get in there either the night before or the morning before I do my talk, and I like to walk the room and kind of mark it, if you will. So I like to feel the chairs and imagine where people are seated, the walls, how my voice carries in the room as well, and just get the whole lay of the land. Because if you go into a cold room, and this actually happened to me one time, I was invited to do a talk at an electric company, and I was expecting maybe 10, 15 people in a conference room. But rather, I was ushered into their office's auditorium with over 100 people there. And I tell you what, I was just like, oh. It was like all this anxiety came about because I didn't know what the room was going to be like. I didn't know how many people were going to be there. And I had my presentation down, but it was a surprise. And whenever there's a surprise when you're doing public speaking, it can create that anxiety, which can then make your presentation just kind of flop. So make sure you walk the room and know exactly where it is and kind of mark it, if you will, and just kind of feel it out. Tip number three, always have contingencies or backups. I was doing a presentation to about 20 people in Toronto, and I was flying from Houston up to Toronto, changed planes in Chicago, all that good stuff. And when I was doing these presentations, I would have all the presentation materials in a nice little Pelican case, weighed about 50 pounds. It would have the projector in there. It would have all the presentation materials and everything that I would give to the people that were attending the workshop. And when I arrived in Toronto to collect my bag, it wasn't there. Not only was the Pelican case with the projector and the presentation materials and all the handouts, that wasn't there, but either was my suitcase with my clothes for the next day and obviously my shave cream for my head. Everything that I needed was not there. And the airline said that they wouldn't be able to deliver it until the next day because I was on the last flight. So what do? You have a backup plan, right? So one of my backup plans is I always have all the materials in the cloud. So I was able to go to the hotel, download those materials, have them printed out so that I at least have the presentation materials for the people. And luckily enough, there's enough clothing stores in big cities like Toronto where I was able to go and get some fresh clothes, shave cream, all the necessities to put on a great presentation. And even though I didn't have the PowerPoint piece of it because no projector, I still gave a killer presentation. In fact, that was one of my highest grossing presentations that I gave, because at the end of those presentations, I would then make an offer, and a lot of people bought that offer because I was just on a roll when I was doing that presentation. Always be prepared with backups and everything that you need to make sure that you give a killer presentation, no matter if things go awry. Step number four kind of goes along with the whole being prepared, but you want to make sure you test out your tech, especially if you're on somebody else's stage. You want to make sure, one, the microphone works, that what would happen if the microphone doesn't work. And that's one of those contingencies where you would want to talk to the sound person and say, if the headset mic goes out, what's the backup? Is there a handheld mic that I can grab real quick? How are we going to fix this if it happens on the fly? The batteries go dead. I always carry extra 9-volt batteries and AA batteries with me in my backpack to make sure that if the sound people don't have the batteries, I have the batteries. And I also have all these different cables as well that for connections for different tech. So if they can't connect to my computer, probably I have the cable in my backpack that has all the cables in there that could ever be used. So always have backups to your tech and test it out to make sure that tech is never an issue. And really, when you're giving presentations anyway, the PowerPoint presentation is just kind of in the background so that it's not the most relevant piece of your presentation. You are presenting to the audience. So make sure you test out that tech, make sure it's working, and you have contingencies for that as well. Number five goes without saying, and I've said this over and over and over again, but practice, practice, practice. Practice some more. Make sure that you have your script all laid out and you know exactly what you're going to be talking about, and you're not just winging it. Because if you wing it, then you're going to be a little bit nervous, like, oh, did I miss that spot? Did I go this? It creates lots of anxiety, and that shows when you are giving your presentation. So make sure you are always scripting it out and you are practicing it multiple times, at least 10. Did I do that right? 10. Yeah, did it right. Tip number six is make sure you're walking the stage. And this goes kind of with that other tip about walking the room. Now you want to walk the stage. Where are you going to plant yourself? Where are you going to start? Where are you going to move to? Where can you move? Where can't you move? Can you get down into the audience maybe? Where do you want to be for your audience? And you just want to kind of map it out, because if you've already gone through one of my programs for dramatic impact speaker training, then you know that I'm all about blocking, making sure that you have places to be for different parts of your presentation. And in this piece, you want to make sure that you are blocking out in different rooms, because some stages are big, some stages are small, sometimes you don't even have a stage and you have this U-shape and it's like doing this whole runway thing. You know, it's just every room is a little bit different, every stage is a little different, and so you want to make sure that you are walking that stage and making sure that your blocking is actually working for that room. And tip number seven is really important, but often overlooked. I always suggest that you exercise first thing in the morning before you do your presentation. That way you have that energy and you've already moved a bit, you're up and at it. And then also drink tons of water. There's nothing worse than having a dry throat when you're doing a presentation and then you're like really self-conscious about, oh, can they hear me in my mouth, in my spit, blah, blah, blah. And it again creates a lot of anxiety, and you definitely don't want that. So drink lots of water, make sure you have water on the stage and ready to go. And the other thing is kind of avoid coffee. I know, I love coffee. First thing in the morning gets me going. But when you're doing a presentation, a lot of times that will dry out your throat and you'll get like this phlegmy and you'll have to cough a lot. It's not a good look when you're doing a presentation. So make sure you have plenty of water, you're well hydrated, and then of course you've gone to the bathroom before you go on stage, because then that's a little awkward as well. And there you go, my 7 public speaking tips, especially for introverts. And you want to definitely make sure that you check out this next video. It's all about how not to sound scripted. Make sure you check that out. And until next time, you have a great day.